Maria! Hey everybody, my 16 channel, welcome back to Smash of the Week, and today we're doing wow, I totally forgot what I'm called or something. We're doing the main topic, whatever it's called, I totally forgot right now. Galactic Warriors. This is all, well, characters, I guess you could say, that's literally fights in space. So, we got Zero Suit Samus from Metroid, Kirby from, well, the Kirby series, Falco from Star Fox, Mario, that's, well, from, like, Mario Galaxy, I should say, Metroid, Samus from Metroid, Fox from Star Fox, Captain Falcon from, F-Zero, and Olimar from Pikmin. So, yeah, I possibly could have, you know, thrown in maybe another character or something, but I don't really know. I think those are, like, the eight characters that I feel like, you know, are deservable for this spot, for this topic, that's it, damn, or theme, I don't know anymore. But anyways, let's see, I'm gonna be choosing, let's see, well, I'm gonna pick, okay, this is what I'm gonna pick: Zero Suit Samus, Kirby, Falco, and just to say, hey, whatever, Olimar, because he's my chicken, you know. Anyways, a really quick thing I want to let you guys all know. This episode's a very special episode. Now, and I mean like super special episode. If you've watched all my past Smash of the Week videos, and I don't mean like all, but at least one or two of them, that you noticed the quality of each video, I just want to say the brightness has been turned down because I've been messing around with my editing software. And there's no way I can literally make every single video's brightness go down to a certain extent, which I was trying to figure out, but apparently I have to do it every single one by itself, so that kind of sucks. So, if you could tell that the brightness has been turned down, thank God, because I believe that's what made the thing didn't look as great. So hopefully this one looks just as great. So I'll be rendering this in HD, 720p at least, you know. And let's just see how it turns out. So, it's not the best, but hey, we'll see what I can do. But if it might be 30 frames, which I hate, but my editing software is weird. But anyways, I don't really have much to say about it, but hey, we're here. So, okay. I have a really quick thing for you guys. Okay? So, a really quick thing to tell you guys, I should say. I was just playing Smash Bros. Not even lying. I was just playing Smash like 30-ish minutes ago, and I swear to God, it's so hard to even fight fair at all on for glory. Now, here's the thing: it is fair, regardlessly. I get that, but this is how I see it, and probably a lot of you might see this too. Just hear me out. Oh, who got out? Falco. Oh, man. One of my picks. So, this is what I see. I feel like everyone on 4 Glory Mode on 1v1 or even 2v2 or even just straight up Smash for Glory picks swords. Swords everything. Be Marth, Lusenia, Ike, Cloud, Shulk, Link, Toon Link. Fuck, if it's like every freaking fucker that you have to play online has to have a sword for some reason in people's minds. And I'm like, what is wrong with people, dude? Like, seriously, I'm so tired of seeing people picking Shulk, Cloud, Link, Marth, Ike. Like, dude, there is other freaking characters that you can pick from. And I'm not gonna lie, a lot of them are pretty good, yeah? A lot of them are good at what they do for the swords players, but the thing is, I am so sick and tired of seeing these sword characters. Who guys? Kind of fucking, okay, he's out. And I don't get why people have to pick them. Okay, I get it, you want to win online. But the thing is, I know For Glory is, you know, 1v1 competition, like it's serious. But in my mind, why can't there be a for fun For Glory mode? Like something in between. I want it to be serious, but not as serious. Like For Glory, 1v1, you know, no items, all that stuff. I get that, but the thing is, I want us to have fun. And a lot of these matches as of late has not really felt that fun. And Olimar is eliminated, and Fox. So, like, it just sucks, dude. Like, I don't want to play for fun because you use items. And I don't want to really play For Glory because everyone doesn't have fun in the shit. I want, like, a certain thing. And you know what's the one thing I really like the most? You randomly sometimes find that person that you just smashed with a while, and you just for some reason connect, and you might have fun with this guy, and you don't even know who the freak it is. But yeah, you were having fun with him, or her. Zero Samus has been eliminated. Okay. I only have Kirby left. Goddamn Kirby. Well, I know he's winning, so that's good. But it's just so dumb. Like, it's so damn dumb. Like, I want something like this. That's, you know, of course, there's a whole four friends. I get that, but it's with friends. And you can't always play with friends online because they're not always be there. So, I don't know how to explain it, but it's just something that bothers me all the time. Including they always pick top tiers, which I get it. Yeah, Fox, Zerus or Samus, Rosalina and Luma, you know, Sheik. Why can't no one just have fun on For Glory? I'm serious. Now, I'm not saying that, oh yeah, the people that's picking these sword and top tier characters are not having fun. They are having fun in a way. But I mean, the fun general way that makes, even when you lose, makes you feel like you had fun, you know? Not the whole, oh my god, you feel salty as hell kind of like feeling. You know, I don't like that all the time. Sometimes, you know, it livens up the freaking, you know, fights, and it makes you want to keep going, but then to a certain point, it's like, you don't care if you even won, you're just like, oh, well, this is boring, you know? And I think it has to be something in between like that, and this is not good for me. So, like, I just announced on Twitter, literally in the last, I don't know, 5 minutes or 10 minutes prior from that time, that I'm seriously want to be done with these Smash of the Weeks. Now, not in a bad way, just in that way, perspectively, because, yes, I have fun talking to you guys within the Smash of the Week videos, and I show you all the freaking fights that I personally have won, and main topics and stuff for the week. But the thing is, I don't always win the matches. I know that. I have never, really, for some reason, never shown you a single match I have lost. Should I? I think I should at one point, but I don't know. Maybe I shouldn't either. Because I personally am not the best Smash player ever. I'm not. I feel like I probably was really good at a point, and I just kind of dumbed down recently. I don't know. But it just feels like, I don't know. It just feels like there has to be something in between. You're probably saying, well, there's Brawl. Well, okay. So, I don't know. It's just something I feel like has to be in between. Anyways, Kirby, you're my chicken. One of my picks won. Nice. All right, everybody. Let's get on to the online matches. So, this is with friends again, which is with MrMagnaRagnarok. He's still going with the Smash of the Weeks, but there will be one special video in here because I only had one video left, and I don't know why I still have one video left. I had one video left of his clip, and it'll be with Jordan as well, MrMagnaRagnarok. MrMagnaRagnarok is Connor, and Jozawa Toad is Jordan. There we go. Sorry. But that's kind of really it for that. So anyways, we got Mario versus Fox. So anyways, I just want to point out that, like, I haven't really talked to my online friends and my good friends online for a while. Now, I hate to say it, but everyone already knows it. I just feel like I haven't really mentioned as much as recently, so people already know in their heads that I'm not going to this event. I was supposed to be going to Retropalooza 4 in Arlington, Texas on October 1st and October 2nd, but the thing is, I had to cancel my plans due to money situations that I don't have enough money to fly there. I will have enough money to fly there, but I won't have enough money to even come back, which sucks, so I'm not getting a flight back. I'm getting basically a one-way flight, which totally sucks. So Even if I was somehow able to go, of course I wouldn't have any money. Now, I shouldn't say it like that, but I kind of feel like I have to. Now, here's why. Yeah, it's good to have money when you go to conventions, stuff like that, and or even just general, like, as a vacation. But I feel like I'd be a nuisance if I even asked for money, and or if I have to, you know, leech off my friend or not, which I kind of hate. But, I don't know, it doesn't feel right to me. And, in, like, there's money situations going on over here at my actual, you know, real life, you know, like, home and family and all that stuff. And that just makes me, like, bummed down a lot, because I actually had the money to go fly and all this stuff. And then family situations has happened, and I totally just, I gived up in reality for a minute. I gived up, like, I just skipped up. I'm like, oh my god, I really wanted to go to sing. But now I have decided, it just feels stupid. Like, I don't know. I'm dumb, okay? I just want to say, I wish I can go, but I can't, and I'm going to miss a lot of good, awesome YouTubers I watch on YouTube. If you are in Arlington, Texas, or just in general Texas, or you're flying to Texas, or you want to do something in 2 weeks from now, or even a week and a half from now, oh shit, that was one hell of a freaking spike right there. Besides that, I would say, you can see the salt right now. Well, yeah, you can sense the salt in the video right now. I just want to say, you're going to meet people like Black Nerd Comedy, Andre Meadows, Alpha Omega Sin, Billy the Game Chaser, what's his name with Jay, Scott Squatch, 8-Bit Eric, GameSack, Metal Jesus Rocks. I can't remember all of them. I really can't. You have to just go to the website and or Facebook page, and it gives you all the details there, but still, I was just something I was really looking forward to, and now it's just died in my mind. And I'm still, you know, looking at all their mentionings on Facebook, on Twitter, on YouTube, and it just bums me down more and more every time I see it. And you're probably saying, well, stop looking at it. I can't, because I want to still feel like I'm going, but I'm not going. If that makes sense. And anyways, back to the whole point of this little conversation. I've, you know, because I'm not able to go, my friend DBZ has been, you know, treating me like I feel like he probably should. It does feel like he should. What the fuck? He's treating me like he probably should, in my personal opinion. Mario won, by the way, next match. And that's basically, you know, not avoiding me, just like, don't really pay attention to me. I feel like I'm avoiding them because I feel like it truly is my fault. And I'm not going to say it isn't, because it's just is. I feel like I deserve this punishment in my mind. I said to myself, I'll try to start talking to them, as in, I feel it kind of the same way for Jordan, so I'm not really trying to talk to anyone as of late online. Maybe like Facebook, Twitter, you know, like messages and stuff like that, but like talk on Skype and sort of like that, I'm not really ready for that yet. Like, I don't know. I just want to feel like I'm getting punished, not because they're punishing me. I just want to feel like I'm getting, you know, like, what's the word? Like, not treatment. Just like I'm getting punished, whatever. In a way, because I know I fucked up, and it's my only punishment I can really think of, so I'm dead inside. Anyways, let's talk about what the freak I've gotten recently, because, you know, that's some sad news, some not sad news, but still, I would like everyone to go check out Arlington, Texas, Retropalooza, Game Chasers, mostly them, about the convention details and all that jazz. About, you know, just going, so. But anyways, besides that, let's talk about what I got recently. So, I have gotten some stuff recently, but I don't know if I really want to talk about some of it. So, let's talk about a few things at a time. Then see how the video goes from there. So, recently, I have finally got myself a dance pad. Now you're probably saying a dance pad? A dance pad. A game pad. No. Well, I don't know what you freaking call it. Maybe it's a dance pad. The dance pad thing that you play Dance Dance Revolution any fucking game. Now this dance pad. Ooh, sorry, I keep wanting to burp. Okay, sorry. Alright. This dance pad, basically it's I'm guessing it's only designed for the Xbox 360 because I see the Xbox 360 logo over there and it's a button. Now, I'm personally wanting the dance pad for the Nintendo GameCube. Why? Because there's only one game I really, really like to have for the dance pad, and that is, of course, Dance Dance Revolution Mario Mix. But the thing is, you know, the game is not hard to come by, and it's not even that expensive, but the dance pad, yeah, it is. And I don't even know if there is any Dance Dance Revolution Dance Dance Revolution whatever mix is on the 360. I mean, it probably is, duh, because that thing exists. But I'm mostly aware of the ones like on PS2 and Xbox and what's not. So, yeah, I'm not really that aware of the 360 ones. And I don't even know if there is, because I don't know if I've seen them or not. And same thing with the PS3s, I don't know if I've even seen those either. So, it's mixed reactions. I just know that Konami made a shit ton of them, and I don't know what they're still doing with them or not. So, still. I believe there's one on like the Dreamcast. I could be thinking some of the Amigo, but I don't know. Or something else. And that's game for that. Alright, Link won. Oh, that was the 3 first match. That was Jordan and Connor. So. I really don't know what to say about that, but still. Anyways, Lucario versus Ness. Anyways, yeah, I finally got myself a dance pad. That's basically it. I don't know if it works yet. I got it for free, so that's why I wasn't complaining. Anyways, the next thing I got was, let's see, what can I talk about? Ah, the Halo Reach statue. Now, I've always wanted this statue, for real. Always wanted it since, well, the launch of the game, ever since the Collector's Edition. And I even said to my friends at some point, this year and last, that the only statues I really want that's game-related is the Marcus Fenix Gears of War 3 statue, which I have gotten also this year, earlier this year, and recently the Halo Reach statue thing. Now, there's only one thing with the Halo Reach one that is problematic. So, on one of the noble teams, it's missing a head, and like three of them are missing a hand. Not an arm, just a hand. So the only one basically complete is like the front one, which is Noble 6, I believe. Well, there's only 5 there, so whatever. Noble, whatever. 1, I guess. I don't know. So it's not the best, but to my personal opinion, I'd rather take that and then not have one at all. Now I got it for $8. So that's why I wasn't really complaining. I'm not really sure if that's the best price for it or not, but hey, I never seen it. I wanted it. I'll get it. Also, like I said, I don't really know if I mentioned that Gears of War thing before. I probably have in this past Smash of the Week videos before. That the gun is kind of loose, and that's was really it, but it's still fine there. So, the only other statue that's game related I'm wanting is the Mila, or Myla, whatever, from Tales of Exilia. I always wanted that. I never got the Collector's Edition, but I just want the statue itself. So that's going to be very interesting to get one day. But there is a statue that will be coming eventually, hopefully someday. And it should be coming, because I ordered it. It should be the very last thing coming anyways. Is a statue I've actually been wanting since watching the anime called God Eater. Now, I'll explain this statue when it actually comes in, because I have to, you know, give my first impressions and stuff on a video, and talk about it here, and in vlog, so it'll be like 3 different times, so. Anyways, yeah, so there's that. Let's see, what else? So, I have, besides a bunch of packages and stuff, I guess I could just talk about this stuff. So, I recently have gotten some more anime-related stuff. Now, this is a weird thing. These anime things are on VHS. And I know there was some anime before on VHS, duh. I just wasn't expecting to find two of them in the same day, especially because I've never really seen them before on VHS, nor ever anything on VHS besides Pokemon. So this is what I was talking about. I found Tenchi Muyo, on VHS. No lie. And I also found, this is probably a good one, which it is, Dragon Ball Z Broly the Legendary Super Saiyan on VHS, which is pretty freaking awesome. And the funny thing is, I have this freaking movie three times. No lie. First time I watched it was online. The second time, the first time I owned it was actually on the four-pack movie collection 2 for Dragon Ball Z, which is like, I don't know, 2 or 3, I forget. And then I also have it just separately on DVD, and now I have it on VHS, so damn, man. that's kind of really for that, and I don't really know. I haven't really tried putting it into a VHS tape because I don't have one in my room. Should I ever get one in my room? In my mind says no, but I don't know if that's a good idea or not, so. Anyways, the next thing I got was a, keyboard. What's so special about this keyboard? It is a Mac keyboard. I have no idea if it works. I haven't really tried it. I got it for literally a dollar, and it's a Mac one. So, this is the reason why. Because it's a Mac, it's more expensive. Like, really, realistically, it's more expensive. Besides being, you know, expensive like a gaming keyboard. But still, you can see Dell, you can see HP, you can feel like all these other freaking brands. But when it comes to Mac, you have to buy it, basically. Because it's, like, something that a lot of people just want to buy, or something just kind of sells. So, yeah, and personally, I just got it because, well, hey, maybe I can assemble a computer the cheapest way possible one day. You never know. But anyways, what else has really been there? I got the Sega Smash Pack 2 on PC. Who won? Lucario won. Nice. Which I didn't even know there was a 2. Or maybe I did on PC and I just didn't even know. So, and the cool thing about this one is, Toon Link versus Yoshi, is that, it's in the box. It's a big box. So, I could say I finally own a big box PC game. The only thing is, it's basically missing, like, everything. Except for the game, itself. Which is with the jewel case and everything. I mean, that's complete. But I mean, like, manual and, like, anything else. It's not even there. It's not even existent. And I don't know why my thing is starting to lag right here, but it's going to start lagging, so sorry about that. It works. I mean, I don't know if it works, sorry. I have it, and I'm going to keep it because, well, I am trying to go for a complete PC Sonic the Hedgehog collection. Which I think that was the part of it, and there really isn't that many. It's just like three or four or something like that on PC, so I don't know if I just barely completed it just like getting that now, or I have to look into more of it. I don't know. I know there's a whole Sega collection thing on PC, so that's kind of what I'm going to go for. Besides that, what else is there? Ooh, speaking of burped in the weirdest way. I do want to say one thing. I've been hanging out with my good friend, and I mean really good friend, Monique. And at first, I was kind of just offering, you know, to give her rides from work to home. And then I realized that she needs a ride to actually get to work as well. And I was like, well, in my mind, I was like, maybe. And then the thing that kind of like, would say, hit the nail on the coffin. She said she lives at her cousin's, which I knew where her cousin lives. And she's like, oh, okay, that's even way better because her cousin lives like 5 minutes away from me. 3-5 minutes, depending, really, but away from me. And I was so freaking excited. I was like, oh, snaps, okay, cool, because I'm cool with her cousin and all that stuff. So, and I think, like, what, 2-3 weeks now? I just wanted to point out. Ooh, sorry, it's burped. I've been getting to know her, and she's actually freaking cool. She likes a lot of shit I like. Mostly the games department, she doesn't really know shit, which is fine, because I've been helping her with actually some games. And I don't know, I just feel good to helping her, because she just like, I'm not going to say she was in desperate need of help, but she kind of really was. And I don't want to say, like, it's a bad way. I just want to say, like, as in, I feel good just helping her because she's a good friend. I feel like I shouldn't be mad or something like that. I just feel like a good person for helping her. And that includes me, you know, seeing my other friend, which is her cousin, a lot more often, which is pretty cool. And I got to a point I kind of got used to just going into their home, not like just walking in like, hey, what up, everybody? No, you know, I knock and, you know, I go in the door and all that stuff. So that's, you know, so I feel pretty, you know, loved in a way. Anyway, I'm not going to say, oh, I'm part of that family, but because I'm not. But basically, I feel pretty good because I feel like in a way I am just like a family friend, you know, because I know like the mom, the three sisters of certain part of the family, then the other three sisters of another part of the family. So I don't know. And then I know there's a brother and all this. I don't know. I feel kind of not connected. I just feel kind of like appreciated in a way. And you might be saying, do I be getting used to you and all that stuff? I get that. I thought about that maybe once. And I was like, well, not really. Because I feel like they've also been helping me in a way too. So I don't know. You can see it as that or not. But still, I feel pretty loved about it. So yeah. Hopefully my friend Monique, you know, keeps going on the right track. She's been changing her life recently. And I really feel for her, for real. Anyways, that was just a little side note I wanted to talk about. So, what else can I talk about really quick? Because it's just about getting near to the end of the video. Not really much I can say, but okay, let's see. I just found out that Azura Striker Gunvolt 2 is coming out physically, but it comes with a pack. It is called the Azura Striker Gunvolt Striker Pack on a Nintendo 3DS, physically, and it's $30 at GameStop. And here's why I really want to get this instead of just downloading Azura Striker Gunvolt 2 on my 3DS. It comes with the first game. I'm like, oh my god. Because I have the first game on the 3DS, but I, you know, I like personally getting physical, not digitally. And I was like, oh my god. And I was like, that's a really good price, because the game, Zero Strike Gunvolt 2, is like a $20 game on the eShop, and the second one's been out for like 2 years now, so that's a good price to get it for, you know, $30, because it's like a $10 game now. So anyways, everybody, that's going to be it for today. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe, leave a comment below, and I'll see you guys all for the next episode of Smash of the Week, which, yeah. Anyways, tell me how the brightness was on this video, and I'll see you guys for the next one, right? Bye.
Chaos Control!